The sheer scale and effort that was undertaken on this earth over a period of thousands of years to depict the gods is just remarkable. No other undertaking in human history or earth civilization even comes close to matching these industrious feats of engineering and artistic brilliance. But what halted this process? At one point in history, the gods, our creators, left. We then began to demonstrate across all civilizations and cultures that we wanted these gods to return. We tried to reach the heavenly place from where they came through building huge structures to reach the sky, and we even eventually managed to replicate the aerodynamics which allowed these beings to travel the earth in the sky. But most of all, and most evident, we have depicted these gods all over the world on a vast scale and in great detail. This effort suggests that the gods were good to us and brought stability to humanity. It also suggests that there were very many gods, or at least governors, that ruled with popular support, much like we see in our establishments today. But what happened to them? Why did they leave? And where did they go? More importantly, will they return? It seems the return of these beings is inevitable. Ancient civilizations knew this, but perhaps they did not appreciate that the timeline of their return was many thousands of years more than they anticipated. One of these gods who was worshipped by the ancient Greek people is in that of Apollo, and just like other creations of their representation of these beings, Apollo is depicted far and wide, and there is even a massive statue that has been dubbed the Sleeping Giant that is of huge curiosity on the scale that was attempted, but just like the unfinished Easter Island statues and unfinished obelisk, this site appears to have been abandoned during the initial carving process. Wait till you hear this. Lying on its back for centuries, the Sleeping Giant is a bit of an enigma. The statue remained incomplete for unknown reasons. Its construction is simple without any decorative features. The statue, which has an estimated weight of about 80 tons, and it has been cut free from the stone on three sides, but it was not completed. On the back of the Kouros, there are keyholes. In the center, between the back of the Kouros and the stone, is a rectangular hole, possibly for the insertion of a wooden lifting beam. These recesses are located in the main lifting points of Greek monoliths. These ancient quarrying techniques can be detected by traces in numerous places in the quarry, since it was not used in later times. The figure lies on a north-south orientation on an incline of about 30 degrees. Dating between the 5th and 4th centuries BC, it is situated in the northern part of Naxos, in the picturesque fishing village of Apollonas. It has a frontal construction with the hands stuck on the ribs and the elbows bent. Moreover, the left leg is longer than the other. The archaic kori has usually been interpreted as depictions of Apollo. On account of its beard, the Kouros of Apollonas has instead been interpreted as the Greek god Dionysus. Scientists say that the ancient sculptors got no further in their plans to transport this Kouros, since a route for the further transport of the statue was never carved into the stone. It is assumed that it was too heavy to transport, even though it is much less heavy than other completed projects in the region. The statue would have been envisioned, then the site would have been scouted, the sculptors handpicked and transported to this place. Then a camp would need to be in place with dozens of helpers to keep the sculptors supplied and fed. So why at this point of the process would they abandon this ambitious undertaking? Also, the curious break in the leg. Officially, it is thought the leg was broken during an attempt to move the statue, but that does not make sense, since it is still in a quarried state. One suggestion was that it was the Germans during World War II who tried to move it with tanks to clear a path and broke it. Greek quarrying during this period was similar to Egyptian quarrying practices. The rough form of the figure was carved out. The sculptors were especially able to work the sides. They worked layer by layer, creating flat contour areas. So the sculptors never worked on a leg, arm, or head individually, but always on the sculpture as a whole, and thus the whole figure was at the same stage of completion at each moment. Only after the creation of the rough contour was the figure rounded out. This is all clearly demonstrated by the Kouros of Apollonas. Two more unfinished, over-life-size Kourori cut free from their quarry, but with their feet broken off. The Kourori of Filario are located at Milan's at Naxos in a village garden. One of these would have been a higher and the other a lower Kouros, i.e. one would have stood 5.5 meters high without a plinth, and the other would have stood the same height with a plinth. From the same marble quarry at Milan's came the roughly 9-meter-high, 25-ton colossus of the Naxians, which was completed and set up on the island of Delos, but is now in fragments. There are also two smaller unfinished quarry at Naxos. One was located in the quarry of Apollonas until Ludwig Ross transferred it to the museum at Athens in 1834. The other came from Filario and is located in the Museum of Naxos on a terrace. Anyway, guys, we just wanted to share this information with you. We find it curious that the further back in history you go, the more accurate constructions seem to be. As we approach the time of Christ, for example, then quarrying seemed much more crude and difficult to undertake. We can't help but feel this is the result of lost technology, and the fact is the bronze chisels used would have blunted very easily. The sleeping giant is, of course, one of the more crude statues from this period, but to us, this suggests the technology was already lost to history at this point, and the ancient Greeks were, in fact, trying to replicate these technologies to depict a god that once would have brought stability and flourish to this region of our planet in the very distant past. We hope you were able to follow what we were trying to say in this video. Check out our playlist if you are new to the channel for a bit of a catch-up, and remember to hit that bell icon so our channel is not lost to you. Let us know what you are thinking. Comment below, and thank you for watching.